Guten Morgen, alle Guten, and welcome to your first Luxembourgish conversation workout. Natural Luxembourgish pronunciation takes practice, you know that. But you want to sound more natural, more casual, just like native speakers do, right? Well, you are in luck, because in this lesson we are going to do exactly that. Now, this lesson is an intensive repeat after me style lesson that is going to help you to strengthen those speaking skills, but as well your listening skills at the same time. Now, today's workout will focus on greetings and introductions. So you will learn some very common questions that you can ask or that you might be asked in some very casual Luxembourgish conversations. Yes, so you will listen to me and then you will repeat those questions after me. So get ready to practice out loud. Bist du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! So when we meet with someone, whether it's someone we already know or someone we are just meeting for the first time, then almost always we ask them how they are, right? So now let's practice some different questions which all mean the same thing. Let's start with, wie geht es? Wie geht es? Salut Marc, wie geht es? Good. Now, have you noticed how geht es, the two words geht es, just sound like one big word, geht es? Salut Marc, wie geht es? Okay, great. Now let's move the emphasis and stress the word geht. Salut Marc, wie geht es? Salut Marc, wie geht es? Great. Or you can say, for example, Salut Fabian, wie geht es dir? Salut Fabian, wie geht es dir? Now notice how the word dir helps to sound really interested in the answer. So if you know someone very well and you haven't seen them for a while, then adding this intonation dir shows that you really care. Let's repeat. Salut Fabian, wie geht es dir? Salut Fabian, wie geht es dir? Good, super. Now let's learn another way to greet someone you know very well. So among native speakers, you can hear people say, for example, at work, amongst colleagues or among friends, Salut Claude, wie ist es? Wie ist es? Now, wie ist es literally means, how is it? And it is commonly used in casual conversations. Wie ist es? Sounds good. And now let's say a way to greet someone even more casual. This is an geht es. An geht es. An geht es. And a last one which is super, super, super casual. An. Yes. So it is very, very common in casual situations among native speakers to just greet oneself by saying ja, et geht, ja, et muss. Great. Now, let's move on with the second set. Let's move on with wat möchtest du? Wat möchtest du? This question is often used to find out what someone's plans are in the future. It is a little question, but which is very useful to start a conversation, or it can help you to keep a conversation going. Now, in the next few questions we will practice, I will start each question with because this helps to give the listener a clue that you are going to say or to ask something. For example, Wat möchtest du den Abend? But in more natural spoken Luxembourgish, you will hear this. An, wat möchtest du den Abend? Listen and repeat after me. An, wat möchtest du den Abend? Wat möchtest du den Abend? You can hear that möchtest sounds more like muss. Wat möchtest du den Abend? And instead of using du, okay, we use the weak form of du, which is de. Wat möchtest du den Abend? So it is very common in spoken Luxembourgish and in questions to use the weak form of du, which is de. And are you still with me? Yes, let's move on. With, for example, an. Wat möchtest du dann de weekend? Or, a wat möchtest du dann de weekend? A wat möchtest du dann de weekend? Put the stress here on dann. A wat möchtest du dann de weekend? Good. Again, it is very common in spoken Luxembourgish to use the word dann in questions. Now, it doesn't change or add anything to your question, but it is there to emphasize what you are asking. A wat möchtest du dann de weekend? And often you will not hear dann, but you will hear da, because dann is subject to the N-word. For example, a wat möchtest du da mua? A wat möchtest du da mua? Or more natural, a wat möchtest du da mua? Let's repeat. A wat möchtest du da mua? So here, dann, you cannot translate it. It does not mean then here in this context. So in a question, it is just an habit to use this, okay? So it's to emphasize your question. And now listen again and you will hear how I link the three words möchtest du da. A wat möchtest du da mua? So you hear more möchtest du da. A wat möchtest du da mua? Great. Now you sound like a native speaker. Great. Let's move on. For example, you can be more casual. So in casual situation, native speaker will just say an. Wat möchtest du dann also? An. Wat möchtest du dann also? So this is very common among native speaker in very casual situations. So just to find out what they are just doing at the moment. An. Wat möchtest du dann also? Yes? Great, let's move on. Another very common question to know what someone's plans are, instead of saying an, wat möchtest du, you can say, hörst du etwas vier? Now listen and repeat after me. Hörst du etwas vier? Notice again that we don't say du, hörst du etwas vier, but we would rather say, hörst du etwas vier? Do you have any plans? Hörst du etwas vier? Or if you want to emphasize this a little bit more, for example, for today, you can say, hörst du heute etwas vier? Hörst du heute etwas vier? Or you can even put more focus on this sentence by saying, hörst du heute schon etwas vier? So here we add the word schon, already. Hörst du heute schon etwas vier? Hörst du heute schon etwas vier? You hear the difference? Great. Or you can combine the two questions we learned now. So you can say an, wat möchtest du de weekend? Schon etwas vier? An, wat möchtest du de weekend? Schon etwas vier? So this is as well very common in casual conversations. And then let's finish this lesson with a topic. So you can move on in your conversation by talking about the family, because it is very common to ask questions about the other person's family. So you can say, wie geht denger Familie? Okay, so you can move on from an, wat möchtest du dann de weekend, schon etwas vier, and then afterwards you can continue by wie geht denger Familie? Wie geht denger Familie? Or if you know the other person better, you can as well ask an, wie geht denger Kinder? Or wie geht dengem Mann? Or wie geht denger Frau. Or you can again add these two words dann so. Zum Beispiel, wie geht es denger Kanner dann so? This is very casual. Wie geht es denger Kanner dann so? And here a last question, which is very, very, very casual. And you can only use this if you know the other person very well. But that's really a common way native speaker speaks. So, for example, An, wat soen ze doheem? Now listen and repeat after me. An, wat soen ze doheem? Great! Now, I hope that you enjoyed this first conversation workout. Of course, there will come some more at a later stage. But this is not a lesson you should listen once. So I recommend that you listen again and that you practice. So you repeat after me, just to practice your oral expression, but as well to train your listening comprehension skills. Now, if you enjoyed this lesson, you know that you can read the full transcript and download the full transcript of this lesson on my blog, luxembourgishwithanne.lu. And if you are a member, you will have access to loads of exercises and lessons on my blog. Now, don't forget, keep practicing. Merci fürs Zuschauen. Thank you for watching.